Hello everyone, welcome to another session of virtual platform of Udayanath Autonomous College of Science and Technology. And now you are watching UN College Digital Class YouTube channel. In this class, we will discuss on the disease caused by bacteria. And in this class, we will briefly discuss about what are bacteria, what are the bacterial infections like foodborne bacterial infection, sexually transmitted diseases due to bacterial infection, different types of skin infection due to bacteria, and we will discuss on these types of bacterial infections and briefly, and also we will discuss about some specific diseases which are occurred due to different types of bacteria, because in our society and in our environment there is different types of bacteria, and the bacteria are coming under microorganism like virus, parasites, and like that bacteria is also a microscopic or microorganism, and it is not visible anytime, and the bacterial infections caused different types of risk factors in our life. So we will discuss on that. First we will discuss on what are bacteria. Bacteria are microscopic single cell organisms that live almost everywhere. Bacteria live in every climate and location on earth. Some are airborne while others live in water or soil. Bacteria live on and inside plants, animals and people. Bacteria means bacteria are microscopic or microorganisms, and the bacteria are living in everywhere in our climate or in our environment. Sometimes bacteria are airborne, and sometimes bacteria are living in water, and sometimes bacteria are living in soil also. And the bacteria are the small organisms because of which the human body infected sometimes, and also some bacteria are good for health. The word bacteria has a negative connotation, but bacteria actually perform many vital functions for organisms and in the environment. For example, plants need bacteria in the soil in order to grow. The vast majority of bacteria are harmless to people, and some strains are even beneficial. When we are heard some word that is related with bacteria, then we have negative connotation and we have negative thoughts about bacteria. But sometimes bacteria are need for our health, and like sometimes plants have need of bacteria for growth and development of the plant. And so there is different types of bacteria, and some bacteria are good for a plant and some bacteria are not good for a plant, and like that some bacteria are not good for health or human body and some bacteria are good for human body. So there is different types of bacteria, and there is some bacteria those which have negative impact and some have positive impact. In the human gastrointestinal tract, good bacteria aid in digestion and produce vitamins. They also help with immunity, making the body less hospitable to bad bacteria and other harmful pathogens. When considering all the strains of bacteria that exist, relatively few are capable of making people sick. And in a human body, due to gastrointestinal tract, there is some bacteria are good for digestion and also create and strengthen our immune system. And when some bacteria are needed for strengthen our immune system, then we have positive impact of these bacteria. And these positive bacteria have impact on our health, and because of these bacteria, we have less need of hospital facilities. And there is some bad bacteria, due to those bacteria the persons are suffering from different types of diseases. Then we will discuss on what is a bacterial infection. A bacterial infection is a proliferation of a harmful strain of bacteria on or inside the body. And a bacterial infection is always harmful for a human body, and there is strain of bacteria inside the body, and due to bacterial infection persons are suffering from different internal diseases, and some diseases are also external. means exposed disease. Bacteria can infect any area of the body. There is no specific area for bacterial infection. Bacteria can infect any area of the body, and there is any type of specific or any type of fixed area for any type of bacterial infection. And next is pneumonia, meningitis, and food poisoning are just a few illness that may be caused by harmful bacteria. There is some diseases like pneumonia, meningitis, and food poisoning are occurred due to different types of bacterial infections. When we are taking food, then we have to take food in a clean utensil, and also we have to cook that food in a neat and clean environment, and we have to maintain the environment hygienic. Due to which hygienic environment we can avoid the bacterial infection. And we have to maintain this type of environment where there is absence of bacteria. Bacteria come in three basic shapes, and these three basic shapes are rod shaped, spherical shape, and helical shape. These are some specific and basic shapes of bacteria. And next is, bacteria may also be classified as gram positive or gram negative. There is two types of classification. One is gram positive and another one is gram negative. And gram positive bacteria have a thick cell wall, while gram negative bacteria do not. And the bacteria are always single celled, and the gram positive bacteria is a thick cell and the gram negative has no thick cell. And next we will discuss on bacterial skin infections. We will discuss on what are the skin infections due to bacteria, and due to which bacteria some skin infections or skins are infected and causes different types of skin related disease. And bacterial skin infections are usually caused by gram-positive strains of Staphylococcus and Streptococcus or other organisms. And common bacterial skin infections include, there is some specific skin infections, and due to gram-positive strains some skin infections arise. And it includes the different types of common bacterial skin infections, and these common bacterial skin infections are, first is cellulitis. And it causes a painful red infection that is usually worn to the touch. Cellulitis occurs most often on the legs, but it can appear anywhere on the body. Specially that bacteria infected the person or the area of the leg, and it can infected other areas also, but specially in legs areas. And next is folliculitis. It is an infection of the hair follicles that caused red swollen bumps that look like pimples. Improperly treated pills or hot tubs can harbor bacteria that cause folliculitis. This bacteria infected specially the part of the hair follicles, and in our head or in some areas, in which area we have hair, there is different types of infections due to bacterial skin infection. And next is impetigo. This bacteria causes oozing sores usually in preschool aged children, and the villous form of impetigo causes large blisters, while the non-villous form has a yellow crust appearance. And this bacteria infected specially the children, those who are preschool children, because when some children are going to school, they have different type of activities, and they are have contact with different types of organisms, due to which they are infected by different types of bacteria. And next is boils. And boils bacteria are deep skin infections that start in hair follicles. Boils are firm red tender bumps that progress until pus accumulates the underneath the skin. This is also a skin infectious disease, and it infected the hair follicles. Bacterial skin infections are treated with oral or topical antibiotics depending on the strain causing the infection. The prevention of bacterial skin infection always depend upon the strain causing of the infection and due to what bacteria or which bacteria the skin infection caused, and it treated with oral medications. And when we are suffering from any type of skin infection, then we have duty for appoint with any doctor or contact with any doctor and share the disease or share the signs and symptoms of any type of skin infection, through which the doctor can prescribe properly for prevention of that disease. And there is always need of oral pills or oral medications, and we can prevent different types of skin infections through medications. Then we will discuss on foodborne bacterial infections. Like skin bacterial infections, there is different types of foodborne bacterial infections, and these bacterial infections are in foodborne bacterial infection, the bacteria infected a human body through food, and in this infection, bacterial infections are one cause of foodborne illness, and the foodborne bacterial infection always causes different types of foodborne illness due to lack of food or due to lack of nutrition. Nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, fever, chills and abdominal pain are common symptoms of food poisoning. When we are not taking proper food or when we are not taking proper nutritious food which is needed for a human body for maintain a healthy life, then we have problem of vomiting, diarrhea, sometimes problem of fever, and sometimes we are facing abdominal pain, and these are some symptoms of food poison. When we are not taking proper neat and clean food and healthy food, then we have problem of food poison, and which causes different types of foodborne bacterial infections. And next is raw meat, fish, eggs, poultry and unpasteurized dairy products may harbor harmful bacteria that can cause illness. And due to raw meat and fish, eggs and also some poultry foods, and when we are taking unpasteurized dairy products, then due to this type of food, the bacteria are harmful, or the bacteria cause different types of harmful illness for human body. Unsanitary food preparation and handling can also encourage bacterial growth and bacteria that cause food poisoning, and it includes means there is some types of unsanitary food, and when we are preparing any type food for taking as our lunch or as our dinner or as our breakfast, then we have to maintain that environment hygienic or neat and clean, and through which we can take a sanitized or we can take proper food which is healthy for a human being. And always we have to maintain sanitary food preparation, and if we are taking unsanitary food preparation, or if we are following the activities like unsanitary preparation at the time of food, then we will face different types of foodborne bacterial infections. And due to different types of food bacterial infections, some other diseases also caused. And bacteria that cause food poisoning, and under this food poisoning, it includes Campylobacter jejuni, means Shi jejuni, which is a diarrheal illness often accompanied by cramps and fever. And this bacteria always cause the symptoms like fever and also sometimes body cramps and diarrhea problem. And next is Clostridium botulinum. Thus, bacteria is a potentially life-threatening bacterium that produces powerful neurotoxins. And this bacteria always produce the neurotoxin, which is very powerful and which is very life-threatening bacterium. And next is Escherichia coli, which is E. coli, is a diarrheal and illness that may be accompanied by nausea, vomiting, fever and abdominal cramps. This also causes diarrhea, fever and the cramps in our abdominal part, and this is also a life-threatening disease. And next is Listeria monocytogenes, and L. monocytogenes causes fever, muscle aches and diarrhea. Pregnant women, elderly individuals, infants and those with weakened immune system are most at risk for acquiring this infection. In these bacterial infections, the problems which is related with diarrhea, fever, abdominal cramps, and also there is vomiting, nausea or stuffy nose problems. And if the infected person is pregnant or old age or very young age or infant, then they have major issues for these infections. And these persons are facing different types of other health issues also, and they have life risk or they have life threatening illness due to this infection. Next is Salmonella, which causes fever, diarrhea and abdominal cramps. Symptoms typically last between 4 and 7 days. It causes different cramps in our body, and which always last between 4 and 7 days. And next is Vibrio, which causes diarrhea when ingested, but it can also cause severe skin infections when it comes in contact with an open wound. And it always causes diarrhea problem, and also causes related with severe skin infections if any contact with an open wound. Then it is infected in spread or transmitted quickly. Next is sexually transmitted bacterial infections. There is some bacterial infections is sexually transmitted, and from one person to another person. If the life partner has any type of bacterial infections, then at the time of relation, the bacterial infection transmitted from one life partner to another life partner. So now we will discuss on some sexually transmitted bacterial infections. Many sexually transmitted diseases or STDs are caused by harmful bacteria. Sometimes these infections are not associated with any symptoms but can still cause serious damage to the reproductive system. Common sexually transmitted diseases caused by bacterial infections. And sometimes there is different types of sexually transmitted diseases due to different harmful bacteria. And sometimes the sexually transmitted diseases, infections are not associated with some specific symptoms. And it also causes different serious damage for reproductive system. And sometimes the parents or sometimes the couple are incapable for reproduction system. And these common sexual transmitted diseases caused by different bacterial infections, and these infections include, first is chlamydia. Chlamydia is an infection in men and women which is caused by an organism called Chlamydia trachomatis, and chlamydia increases the risk of pelvic inflammatory disease in women. Mainly affected the women specially, and it also affected the men and women also both, but specifically to the women. And the next is gonorrhea, and it is also known as clap and the drip. It is caused by Neisseria gonorrhea. Men and women can be infected by this bacteria, also increases the risk of pelvic inflammatory disease in women. And next is syphilis, and syphilis can affect men and women and is caused by the bacteria treponema. And untreated syphilis is potentially very dangerous and can even be fatal. Sometimes the syphilis bacteria are very dangerous or very harmful for the men and women also, and due to this bacteria infected, some persons are incapable for reproductive system. And next is bacterial vaginosis, and it causes an overgrowth of pathogenic bacteria in the vagina. and this also causes different types of sexually transmitted disease due to this type of bacterial infection, and sometimes men and women lost their reproductive system. And this is all about the diseases or all about the bacterial infections which are sexually transmitted bacterial infection. And next is other bacterial infections. In other bacterial infections, first we will discuss on the bacterial meningitis. This is a severe infection of the meninges and the lining of the brain. This bacterial infection affected the brain of the human body. And next is otitis media. This is the official name for an infection or inflammation of the middle ear. And both bacteria and viruses can cause ear infection, which commonly occur in babies and small children. And in otitis media, sometimes mainly the babies and the children are suffered by different types of otitis media bacterial infection diseases. And it is mainly affected the ear of the babies and the small children. And next is urinary tract infection. And in UTI is a bacterial infection of the bladder or urethra, kidneys or uterus. And this is a bacterial infection also, and which infected the intestinal part of the woman mainly. And next is respiratory tract infections, which include sore throat, bronchitis, sinusitis and pneumonia. Bacteria or viruses may be responsible for respiratory tract infection, and tuberculosis is a type of bacterial lower respiratory tract infection. And respiratory tract infection has different types of affected, like sore throat, bronchitis and sinusitis and pneumonia. And the major bacterial infection or respiratory tract infection is tuberculosis, means TB. And this infected a person very seriously, and some persons have different health issues and different life risk health issues or diseases due to this type of bacterial infections. Next, we will discuss on bacterial disease, any of a variety of illness caused by bacteria. There is different types of bacterial diseases and it caused illness for a human body and infected by bacteria. And next is, until the mid 20th century, bacterial pneumonia was probably the leading cause of death among the elderly. Until the 20th century, the disease pneumonia, which is affected the human being due to bacterial infection and also sometimes leading the cause of death if the persons are elder person. And in the early 21st century, tuberculosis, which is caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis, several strains of which had developed resistance to one or more drugs widely used to treat the infection, was among the deadliest infectious diseases worldwide. In 20th century, the disease that is pneumonia, but in 21st century, the disease that is tuberculosis, it means TB, which caused or which infected the human being in major numbers, and more number of people are suffering from the tuberculosis disease. And sometimes this disease also leading the death, because if some persons are not aware about the tuberculosis disease and some persons are not aware about how they can prevent this disease, so that those persons are suffering from tuberculosis disease and not prevented or not cured that disease at the right time, then they are suffering from different health issues, and also sometimes it leads to death. This is all about this session, and in this class we had discussed about what are bacteria, what are the bacterial infection, and also discussed about some diseases which are infected due to bacteria, like skin bacterial infection, sexually transmitted bacterial infection, and also discussed about foodborne bacterial infections also, and how we will prevent these bacterial infections and what are the risk factors for bacterial infections. These parts we will discuss later in our next class. Keep watching. Thank you. Have a great day.